We're going back in time on American Idol tonight.
That's right. The eight remaining contestants singing hit songs from my wheelhouse, the 80s. Really loved it. Let's welcome in USA Today music writer and Idol blogger Brian Mansfield, also young man at that time.
That's right. My wheelhouse as well. All right, we're all showing our age now, right? Brian tonight got off to a rocking start with Jenna Irene singing I Love Rock and Roll. Let's check her out.
Okay.
All right, Keith Urban said he loved it. He loved her arrangement change-up of the Joan Jett song. What did you think, Brian?
Well, and what you don't see here is that she really started the song much differently from the version that we're all used to, kind of softly at the piano in a minor key, and was able to do a whole lot with the song, which is one of the things that you want to be able to do at this stage of the competition, put your own stamp on it.
I've not been a huge fan of Gina's to this point, but I thought she had one of the better performances of the night easily.
I agree with that.
It was captivating for sure.
Now let's hear from Alex Preston, who did his version of another huge 80s tune by The Police, Every Breath You Take, very different. Told you it was different. Now, you know, Harry said, you know, hey, man, this is great. You put your own spin on it. But at the same time, he criticized him for saying this coffee house routine you're doing is going to catch up with you.
Yeah. And Alex still needs to kind of figure out, as Harry was saying, the difference between being a performer and being an entertainer. But this was one of the few songs tonight where the changes that the singer made to the melody really suited his strengths as a performer. It was like you said, it was a very different version of the song, did a lot of push and pull with the timing and the melody, and really changed the kind of song that it was. But it worked for him. It really told you more about who Alex was than just showing you Alex singing a song.
Good perspective there, although the song, I'm With Scott, was almost unrecognizable.
I love Brian McKnight's version, too. Dig that song.
All right, finally, let's check in on Caleb Johnson. He brought the house down with Journeys Faithfully. Get the lighters out. There's the lighter. Keith got the lighter out. All right, Harry says Caleb showed a more subtle side tonight. He was proud of him. J-Lo thought Caleb was really out of his comfort zone. So who's right, Brian?
Yeah. Well, they both kind of were. Because what J-Lo was saying was that it was something that Caleb's not used to doing because he was singing much more softly, which he said that he would do. And you don't really see it from this clip because this clip is all the pyro and the big notes.
Yeah.
But this was a much more subdued, much more reverential kind of performance than the big rockers that Caleb is used to doing. And that's something that he really needs to show that he can do. And he can't wait too much longer to do it or it could backfire on him.
He was doing great early, may have lost a little bit of steam tonight. I don't know that he's going to be in the bottom three, but he could be.
No, I don't think so.
Especially
not ending the show, because the person that ends the show almost never ends up in the bottom three.
Because you're the last person to get a chance to say vote for
me. Exactly.
Fresh in the memory. All right.
Our thanks, as always, to Brian Mansfield, USA Today music writer and Idol blogger.
We do appreciate you coming in. And please tune in tomorrow night at 8 o'clock for the American Idol Results Show right here on Fox 17.